Hey, Nick Delgado here with Ibok Ibokulous.
Ibok Ibokulous here on Instagram and Facebook. I'm on so many cameras, I don't know what to do right now. It's study day at Dr. Delgado's office for me. I'm in his library, yoga, lifting weights, and mostly studying, a little bit of arguing. That's our weekly routine. I love his library. There's books everywhere. Today we were studying hormones today. I gave a talk on a Facebook group about the nutrition necessary for optimal brain functioning. Nick chimed in about trace minerals. And then we got to talking about hormone levels. And we had a interesting talk, especially about cortisol. And he actually wanted to get live, and I wanted to share with my network about some of the misconceptions of cortisol. And everybody thinks of it as such a bad thing. And Dr. Nick is the hormone expert. I think they recognized him as a sex doc because he got so many men back working again. But through that, he became an expert in all things hormonal. And even before that, with certain situations that happened in his life. But he is the number one person I know when it comes to hormones. And he is here to explain some critical things about cortisol that I think everybody needs to know.
Ibok, first I want to bring up a point. What does Robin Williams, Whitney Houston, Elvis Presley, Michael Jackson, what do they have in common? Now, Robin Williams died at age 63, Whitney Houston, age 48, Elvis, 42, and Michael Jackson, only 50 years young. What was it they had in common? You know, it's interesting.
They were rich.
They were rich. Michael Jackson was vegetarian, vegan. Elvis wasn't.
Yeah.
Whitney Houston, I'm not sure about her diet, nor am I familiar with Robin Williams' diet. But they have one thing in common.
Yeah.
They had a severe hormonal deficiency of cortisol. It's called hypocortisolemia. They couldn't produce enough cortisol. And when you can't produce enough cortisol, your body will seek methods to release or increase the production of cortisol. So it turns out that resorting to addictions, drugs, alcohol, sex, these things will release cortisol, overeating.
So most people think low cortisol is a good thing, and you're saying that it's not a good thing.
It's terrible.
Okay.
It's about the worst thing you could have, because you could live months, weeks and months without thyroid, without testosterone, without DHEA. Yeah. Cortisol, you could not live more than minutes, hours or so. I mean, literally, it's that critical.
Well, what would happen to you if you were without it for that amount of time?
Well, first, the body has a lot of backup systems. The first backup system, it's called drama. So a person will try and evoke an argument. They'll get upset. They'll get angry. They'll scream at you, literally just seem like out of control. And you're wondering, where did this come from? I didn't do anything to cause this.
Okay, so all women have low cortisol.
Well, we call it drama queen. That's where that comes from.
Okay.
And not all women, but women who get upset like that. And then it's weird because...
And men too, right?
Oh, sure, men can have. Yeah. Absolutely. And
when the opportunity here. Okay.
So when the cortisol level drops so low, your mind and your body's going, you know, trying to resort to something, so it resorts to getting angry or upset. And once they get a rise out of you, their cortisol level goes up. When I mean a rise out of you, an interaction, some kind of a severe, you know, emotional outburst or interaction, then their cortisol comes up and they calm down and you're still upset. And you're like, what, you know, what, now all of a sudden you're okay? What's up? So once you know you're dealing with a drama queen or a drama king, you just got to know that their cortisol is severely deficient. Their adrenals are not producing enough adrenaline. Mm-hmm. Now, if they're constantly, you know, they're out on a date and one drink's not enough, they have a second, a third, a fourth, they have to get drunk. Mm-hmm. If they have to really get blazingly drunk, the body,
like that.
Yeah, the body will release cortisol.
Okay.
So it's
a big part of addiction that you're saying, like this hormone imbalance can make it easier for people to seek things that they get addicted to get that rise.
Yeah, and think about certain common drugs, cocaine, other methamphetamine, so forth. These drugs release or indirectly increase the pathway of cortisol. So the person feels better, partly because they're getting a solution to their deficient cortisol. If you solve the cortisol problem...
Cocaine's a hell of a drug.
Yeah, if you solve the addiction, if you solve the core of the addiction, the person at least emotionally has a chance to seek help. Otherwise, they're physically and emotionally addicted to it. And, you know, and people like Robin Williams, I mean, it's sad because here he was fighting depression. He was known alcoholic. What medications he used, I mean, I'm sure we could look up the history. But had he received help and had he optimized his hormone levels by a doctor who understood, you know, like myself, and when you read the book, Safe Uses of Cortisol, the original title was Safe Uses of Cortisone, by William McKinley Jeffries. But people saw this book and they go, cortisone's bad for you. It's a corticosteroid and it's a synthetic and it you feel better initially. It was like a miracle drug. Mm-hmm. The Nobel Prize was awarded for the discovery of cortisol. Okay. It was that important because it actually cured arthritis immediately. It was like the wow. ultimate anti-inflammatory.
I read a couple pages of that book and I'm like, what? Okay, people need to know about this because this is, I had a misunderstanding about it. So that's awesome.
It's huge, and I would say 95% of doctors do misunderstand the great importance of cortisol and how helpful it is and how important it is for your body to produce enough.
Cured arthritis. Like, absolutely. You're gonna have to expand on that. Like, that's crazy.
Well, think of most diseases, particularly arthritis, as an inflammatory disease.
Of course.
Think of autoimmune diseases. Autoimmune disease, Hashimoto's of the thyroid. If you're talking about the gut, Crohn's disease, if you're talking about
every disease is inflammation.
Directly or indirectly, yes. As we age, there's an increased rate aging of inflammatory process. It turns out that cortisone decreases the inflammatory process, okay? Hydrocortisone is produced naturally by the body, cortisol, but...
Okay, cortisone or cortisol is the anti-inflammatory.
Okay, they are actually two distinct molecules that have similar actions in the body. Mm-hmm. When doctors make prednisone, a corticosteroid, it's a synthetic form of cortisol. But think of cortisol as you only have 40 milligrams that your body produces or needs in a day. Even under stressful conditions, maybe you need a little bit more. But what happens is with the body is that we go through this process of seeking a way to produce enough of this hormone cortisol. And so low cortisol, Lady Diana, she had a classic look. People with low cortisol, they have thin, hollow face. You see the picture of her, the blonde with the little earrings there next to Marilyn Monroe. Diana has the classic look of a model, right? Usually it's that, you know, hollowed, thin, hollow face, and they kind of look like a model, right?
Okay.
But that's a sign that their body's not producing enough cortisol.
Well, what about the guy next? His face is not thin or hollow.
Right. That's the famous Winston Churchill. Now, he had very high growth hormone levels. He had a very high, a large forehead, his superior face, large nose. You can see kind of the aspects of that. Thick eyebrows, pronounced nose, you know, the chin, you know, very pronounced chin.
What about Gandhi? You got my boy Gandhi over there. What's up with him?
Well, Gandhi also had apparently high growth hormone levels. I mean, look at his nose. Look at that again. The forehead. I think
that's because he's Indian.
Well, certain nationalities do have certain hormonal distributions.
Okay.
Mao Zedong had low thyroid, swollen lower eyelids. He had excess DHT. You know, bald. He had low testosterone. That's another sign of being bald.
And if you want to see the slides, they're on Dr. Nick's page on your Facebook page, right?
Well, DelgadoProtocol.com.
DelgadoProtocol.com.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Marilyn Monroe had the perfect balance of hormones. I mean, she perfect estrogen, thyroid, her hair was shining, her face beautiful, brilliant eyes. I mean, just everything was great about Marilyn. So you think about famous people, it's a good way to kind of, you know, identify hormone deficiencies. But thinking of Lady Diana, low cortisol, back to our subject, if your body has adrenal dysfunction, you're going to eventually develop chronic fatigue.
Yeah.
And if you develop chronic fatigue, like under normal stressful situations, you're seeking a date coming Valentine's Day and the girl turns you down.
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty depressing. It's upsetting. Some guys will just literally just fall apart, want to go lay down and go to sleep. You know,
right.
You have to have a high enough cortisol level to interact with a smart female. Women are smarter than us, so we got to be sharp.
Sure.
We got to be quick.
Right.
So if we're quick, they see, they notice. We're quick, they're interested in us. If we're slow to think, slow to process, it's a sign our cortisol level's low.
Nick was telling me that, you know, this guy's tested more people's hormone levels than anyone I know. I do my clients' hormone testing through him as well. And he's saying that, you know, when he looks at people who have high cortisone, or low cortisone, he always asks them about how they handle stress. And he finds that the people with high cortisone, they're just like, yeah, no problem. Like, no, stress doesn't affect me. But the people with low cortisol are always like, oh, it's just
devastating.
They're
wiped out. They get fatigued. They want to lay down and go to sleep for hours when they're under stressful situations.
Right.
They have to take a nap. They have to resort to coffee, something to stimulate them, because that's like Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson had to drink Coke, was it Coke or Pepsi? He would drink it all day long to get ready for his concerts at night. And, you know, so he would stay awake and perform, but it eventually burned out his adrenal. So then he had to take a med to go to sleep at night. He couldn't sleep. So people have these imbalances. It's just devastating to people. You know, I think about Elvis Presley. He overate. He ate tons and tons of food.
Hey, Carrie.
And so Elvis Presley, you know, here's a guy that they reportedly, he was consuming something like 10,000 calories a night.
Damn.
He would eat just big steaks and big hoagie sandwiches. And I mean, just massive amounts of food. And I saw him perform near the end of his life. I mean, he was at the Hilton Hotel in Las Vegas. And, you know, he was really heavy by that point. You know, he just got heavy. And, you know, he was in great shape through most of his career. And when his cortisol level just flattened out and during all that stress.
That's why he was so addicted to food.
Yes.
Because he was trying to
raise his cortisol level.
Okay. So that's really powerful. We got five more minutes, and then we're going to be done because we're keeping a specific time. I want to say hey to Ray, Jerome. I don't know who we got over there on Instagram because it's a smaller screen. But that's really powerful.
So anyone who's overeating,
yeah.
who's addicted to food, and they
yeah.
can't, like Hari Hachibu, we were talking about, in Japan, they have a very important practice where they eat up to 80% of their calories, and then they stop eating for dinner, and they let the food digest, absorb, and it absorbs, and then they're done eating. They don't overeat. Here, we just keep eating, and the reason some people continue to eat more and more food, they don't feel satisfied because the food they're absorbing, they don't have enough cortisol to push the glucose, fatty acids, amino acids into the cells. So they're starving even though they've overeaten.
That's crazy. So it's easier to form addictions because all the things that we're addicted to stimulate our body's response of cortisol. And so I guess the next question is, how do we balance those cortisol levels? How do we raise the cortisol levels? And is there, when is too much too much?
Right. So in the books by Dr. James Wilson, who I've interviewed on my YouTube channel, Adrenal Fatigue and Building Wellness with DMG. DMG is a methyl donor, dimethylglycine. TMG is a methyl donor,
yeah.
MSM. So we created a product called NeuroInsight. And yeah, CoQ10 also helps. So NeuroInsight gives you the key methyl donors, phosphatidylserine. And so what it does is it helps the liver to process and create more energy. So one of the problems that people have with low cortisol is they're fatigued. So you want to approach restoring their energy, not just by restoring the adrenals. You want to prop up the function of the liver. So because that's the main source where all biochemistry, all energy is created in the liver besides the mitochondria of the cells. So when you start increasing the production of energy, you start feeling better. Now, you also have to take a product called Adrenal DMG, which is that one right there. You take Adrenal DMG, the adrenal cortex, echinacea, ashwagandha. So there's different ingredients there that support and rebuild the adrenals.
What was that group that you said had good cortisol? Was it in, you just mentioned it.
Well, the production of cortisol, you're talking about the category of herbs and so forth, or
No, you were talking about a group of people that had good cortisol and the reasons why.
Oh, I mean, you think of Okinawans.
What are the natural ways to that?
Certain roots, certain herbs.
Okay.
Certain herbs and roots. I mean, these people, you know, I mean, herbs is part of their Asian medicine. Okay. Okinawans, instead of using drugs, they use herbs. And these herbs, I mean, the culture that eats a lot of astragalus, they say they point to that herb. They say, eat that herb and you'll live longer. I mean, they've known from thousands of years that this particular herb helps people to live longer. So we think about, and here's a list of ingredients, adrenal DMG, dimethylglycine, that helps the liver to function. And then we use adrenal cortex, licorice root, ashwagandha, echinacea, lodium dissectum. So these herbs actually help to support and rebuild the adrenal gland, which is located above the kidney. Then you start producing enough cortisol. You need to get to sleep on time. Don't stay up all night. You know, get to bed earlier, 8 or 9 o'clock, 9, 10 o'clock, somewhere around there, the peak amount of hormones are produced. You'll wake up with strong morning erections. You'll wake up feeling refreshed. Yes. You should never have to wake up with an alarm. You should think backwards. How many hours does it take? I set a timer. And if you get that 8 hours, some people need 9 hours, some need 10 hours, some need 6 hours. Mm-hmm. But somewhere early on, when you produce enough of these hormones, you'll wake up refreshed and ready for the day. But it might take weeks to get your sleep cycle on track, so you're not sleep deprived.
So you have to support your liver. Did you say you have to support your kidneys as well?
Well, above the kidney is the adrenal glands.
Adrenal glands.
And the adrenal glands require these herbs, and also outdoor daylight stimulates massive amounts of cortisol. Getting outdoors in the daylight. I work out outdoors. I mean, that's where I work out. So I get a little tan, not as tan as you, brother.
Dude,
but we're getting there.
I'm catching, man. Came back from a cruise. I'm like, bruh. Like, bro, you got to put on sunscreen, dude. You're dark.
Yeah, but see, that sun gives you 500,000 lux of energy, which helps the adrenals produce cortisol.
Yeah.
If you're indoors all the time, if you're indoors all the time, the lights. I use special lights that produce a little bit more lux of energy, but generally speaking, you're not going to get that cortisol production. So you need at least 30 minutes to an hour outdoors.
All right, so. Our body needs herbs to stimulate adrenal function and liver function.
Yes.
And when you, so your body also needs more sleep and, you know, a balanced diet. We all know that. But taking some supplements like these, how quickly do you think they would feel an improvement if they're, you know, especially when it comes to, you know, people that are dealing with, you know, urges that they feel have control over them and are listening to this and are saying, hey, maybe my hormones are off. First, you should get your hormones tested all day. If Alexis gets on here, I just sent her a hormone test and the list of hormones to tell her doctor to do. So her insurance might pay for her hormone test. But most doctors don't understand hormones like this guy. So I use his list of hormones, like, demand that your doctor test these because they don't know what they're talking about. So not on everything. So make sure they get those hormone levels so we can coach you on that. So definitely get your hormones tested. And then if you're experiencing this addictive personality in your and you're trying to figure out where it's from, or addicted to food, and you fly
off the handle, like out of control emotionally, and you can't seem to control yourself. You don't know where it's coming from. Could be a sign your cortisol is very, very low, and your body's just trying to react to, like, rise it up a little bit. Or if you overeat, you chronically overeat. I mean, I think back when I was, you know, a teenager, I mean, I'd eat literally 5-10 plates of food. I mean, I won a contest, 3 eating contests at the county fair, and I won one against my football team. I ate 22 plates of food at King George, Sir George's in Arcadia. I mean, these guys, I was 240-pound, 280 guy, and I out-ate them because I had this low cortisol. I didn't know. All these years, I had low cortisol, and I was never satisfied. No matter how much I ate, I just kept eating.
He had a stroke at 26.
22. Yeah.
22.
So fortunately, once I learned I had low cortisol, I started out personally on hydrocortisone prescription. I was taking about 20 milligrams twice a day of time release, and it solved my problem. Oh my God, I could finally eat one plate of food and I was satisfied. I finally didn't crave things. It was like crazy. If you crave sugary, spicy, salty foods, you have low cortisol. And so once I solved that, then I transitioned to now how, okay, that's the hormone I need, but what do I need to do to rebuild my adrenals? And it took me 2 years, you asked me the question, of taking adrenal DMG and using methyl donors. Now we have the high-end NeuroInsight, and that combination, after 2 years, I don't need hydrocortisone any longer. I don't have to use it. It's completely, my production of cortisol based on my urine tests, my saliva tests, my blood tests is perfect. And I handle stress immaculately. I mean, who do you know who has to handle how many different hats, hang out with five kids, you know, my children, 9 to 39,
baby mamas,
and going at it nonstop, right? And then I train like a madman. I used to train like that, and I'd crash and burn, have a cold or flu, and couldn't recover for weeks.
This guy's savage, dude. He really lives this. he really pushes his stress levels. I mean, this is stressful right here. Like,
this is fun. I'm having a blast.
10,000 books in here. It's crazy. But yes, okay, awesome. We're gonna get off. We really appreciate you guys. Get your hormones tested. It's not very expensive. What's our deal on the hormone test right now?
You can get if they go to DelgadoProtocol.com, they just click on hormone testing, and then they're listed there. And I mean, you know, they're essentially our cost to do them. But you know, at the website, there's a little section there, and it talks about what is your number one health goal, and you can enter that, and you can take a look at you know, different energy things going on, PCOS, and you know, acne, heart disease, A to Z, all these things.
The new Delgado Protocol site, DelgadoProtocol.com. Oh,
and I'm so excited about that NLP
hit me
event.
Hit the DM, and I will send you the link.
Yeah, the event Saturday, February 17th. You're going to be there,
event
right?
Plug.
Saturday, 10 in the morning.
10 to 2.
2, yeah. It's going to be right here, close
to
the
17th,
Mesa.
Right?
And we're going to live stream because not everyone can show up. But it's Saturday the 17th, February. Yeah.
Show up if you can.
Next Saturday after
Peace
this.
Peace out, guys.
And by the way, this weekend I'm at the LA Conscious Life doing a lecture on Saturday.
With Goatman. Shout out to Goatman. What's up, baby?
So, yeah. So check it out, guys.
All right,
show
cool,
up.
Cool.
Be there or be square. Let's get your cortisol under control, your thyroid, your testosterone, your DHEA. There's about 10 different hormones we really want to kind of get corrected. So it's like $150 for
Alex
a saliva
Clark,
test.
Are you, do you ever get crazy? Alex, let me know if you ever go crazy on Panopino. Your cortisol might be low. Just looking out for my boy. No, I just play it. I love you, girl. All right, bye, guys.
All right, everyone. Take care. NickDelgado.com. Share it on social media if you have any comments. And also, once a week, we choose a winner. If you interact with us on social media, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and we'll choose a winner, and we'll reach out to you, and we'll send you one of our key products, whether it be the methyl donor, which is amazing, called NeuroInsight, or we'll send you an adrenal DMG, which can repair your adrenals at the source of. And one of your favorite products, Stay Young.
Give me that.
It helps with the telomeres, astragalus. It's got the methyl donor as well. And
they taste delicious.
They do. They're just
my snack.
Munch on these puppies.
It's
They're
perfect.
So good. All right, everyone. Take care. Be well. Be strong. We'll see you at the next event.